Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jaison Mathew. When I gone through multiple scenarios on LWA, the part one video became too lengthy and I decided to break it into multiple videos. So this is the second part of or the continuation video of LWA configuration on Cisco WLC. Let's get started. Now, let's see how we will be able to use the external server. So as I said, this particular external server, I'm using WebAuth bundle and I put it in a server. But if you already have an ISE and if you want to use the ISE as a login portal, you can also do the same thing. So what are the configurations I have in the ISE? I'll just show you the configuration on my ISE. So this is my ISE setup. Then under work center, I'm going for portals and components. So I have a portal created here. So that is called as LWA. The portal configuration for LWA, I made it very simple. So I didn't done any customization. It's a standard portal. So this is the name I given, portal as LWA. So when you click on this portal test URL, you will be able to see that URL here. Then basically this is the portal you are going to get it inside our web authentication. So whenever this client is asked for a web authentication, this is the page going to come there. So this is the portal. Then I have another configuration for policy. So there is an authorization profile I created. So authorization profile is using LWA profile. So there is no major configurations. Basically I given LWA. And I have web authentication enabled here, local web authentication. And other than that, I don't have any configuration on this page. So basically only this one, there is no redirection page, nothing like that. This is LWA, local web authentication, only one checkbox, that's it, nothing else. So this is my configuration and I'm going to redirect this authorization profile or the portal in my WLC. Now what you have to do is you have to map this portal as an external redirect on the WLC. So I'm going back to WLC and under WLAN, I'm going to do WLAN security layer 3. Then external redirect, I'm going to change this one into a ISE portal URL. So I pasted that particular link here. So this is the portal link and I'm going to apply this. And now we should be getting a login portal from ISE. So login portal means ISE is going to give the login page for us in this scenario. So let's see how that works in the background. So for that, let's go and DO this client. We'll remove this client. Client is removed. You can see that this particular guy is getting timed out. Now let's go into the login page. I'm typing cisco.com. Then I got the login page and I'm going to fill the username and password here and click on sign on. And that authentication got passed. And now we have to click on this continue to start using the network. Click on continue. The authentication is passed. Then you will be able to see the communication is starting. So even though this particular guy is using ISE as a login page, still the authentication is done by the WLC. Here you can see the client. It's got connected with JSON username. Then you can see this guy is in local and run state. Now let's make it a little more complicated. We have external redirect and all those things, but let's make it complicated by adding the mobility anchor. For doing mobility anchor, you know, you should have your mobility group members. So mobility group members, I have my WLCs. So as you can see here, I have multiple WLCs, but I'm going to use this guy 198 as a anchor here. So this is my 198, the IP address of 198, and this is my WLAN under anchor. In security configuration, it's same. L3 configuration, I have the same thing, and I have external redirection coming from ISE. Then we have AAA server configured with ISE. Then advanced settings, I don't have anything changed. Everything is a default configuration when you create an SSID. So I'm going to apply this configuration. And another thing is I have mobility anchor configured here. Under mobility anchor, you can see locally I added this guy as an anchor. So basically this particular SSID is locally anchored to this particular anchor WLC. So this is the anchor WLC. It's a virtual WLC, and this is the configuration on WLAN. Okay, so now let's add this guy as an anchor on the foreign WLC. So here I'm having the same configuration. So as I said, I have the same configuration on this particular SSID, but I have to add a mobility anchor. So to add mobility anchor, you have to put it in. You have to go inside mobility anchor. Then you have to select the IP address. So 198 is my anchor configured here. So this is my WLC going to be the anchor. So I'm going to select that anchor here and click on mobility anchor create. Then click on yes. Then going back. So now the mobility anchor configuration is done. So we are doing LWA. We are doing the LWA with external redirection with your ICE server. And on top of that, we are adding a mobility anchor. So this is how we will be able to add the mobility anchor on top of this one. So basically, the requirement is simple. If you are using this one as a guest access traffic, you have to do the isolation of the traffic. So whatever communication coming from your clients, wireless clients, should go through a tunnel so that it is not exposed to your infrastructure or your corporate network. And it will go into the anchor. In our scenario, this is our anchor WLC. This WLC is sitting behind our DMC zone, and this is going to terminate the traffic in the DMC zone. So this is how our configuration is. Now we have LWA, we have mobility anchor. So in anchor controller also, we have our ACL configured. So we have ACL configured here. Whenever you do mobility anchor, you should have identical configuration other than some of the items like interface mapping, radio policy, and all. You need identical configuration. So in security L3 side, you have the same ACL name and it's mapped to that ACL, and you have an ACL in the background. Now let's test this combination with the anchor. So LWA with anchor. Let's go to the client and see how this one is behaving in the background. And how this mobility anchoring is taking place on your guest access client. Now we are on the client. Let's get connected to LWA. So now this one is got connected to the SSID and it got the IP address, but it's not able to communicate to its own gateway. So I'm going to do the login. So as you can see, this login page is coming again from ICE as per our configuration on WLC. On the anchor WLC, and I'm clicking on sign on, and then continue, and the authentication is successful and it's able to communicate with the gateway. What you have to keep it in mind is right now looking wise everything is same, we did the same process on the client side, but there are a lot of things happening in the background on the WLC side. Right now I'm on anchor, and you can see there is a client connected to this anchor. Then when you go to that client, you will be able to see the username, same stuff. But when you go into the client inside that client, the mobility role is getting changed. So as you can see here, mobility role is export anchor. So this is what happens when you have anchoring WLC that supports your guest access. It will get into mobility role as export anchor. Let's go and check the same condition on the other WLC. Let's go into the client page, and you can see this particular client is there and username is unknown. And we'll go into the client and you can see mobility role as export foreign. So the key thing here is when we talk about authentication, the entire L2 authentication happens on foreign and L3 authentication happens on anchor. So this is what happens in the LWA scenario. So as you can see here, username is unknown for this guy. The client is associated to this guy, but the problem here is it's not even the L2 authentication is not there. It's an open one. But in the previous scenario, the entire authentication, everything was run here so that you'll be able to see the username. But in case of mobility anchor scenario, the L3 authentication always happens on the anchor. So as you can see here, this guy did the authentication, and you can see he knows about this client. CWA, we are actually doing an L2 authentication that is taken care by your foreign WLC, and the data plane is handled by the anchor. So don't get confused on LWA and CWA. So now whatever we talked about web authentication, that is completely on LWA. This is not the way CWA works, so I am going to cover CWA in a different video. But these are the combinations you can actually get it when you are planning to use LWA. Use cases are based on your requirement, but this is how you will be able to do LWA in your network. So we talked about internal authentication. We talked about customized authentication page, login page, then external redirection. Even in external redirection, we used two different type of servers. So we in external redirect, we see the external redirect using a normal web server, and we also see external redirection using an ISE server. So these are the two different methods we shown in this video. And it also shows how this one is working with an anchor scenario. So these are the areas that we covered in these videos. Hope this video will help you in configuring LWA kind of setup for guest access. If this is your requirement, you can actually do this. If you are having a small scale setup, and if you don't want to go into a complicated ISE-based CWA, this is one of the method you can use. You can, instead of ISE, you will be able to use any kind of radio server, and you will be able to use this kind of customized web both bundle and all those things. So external servers and all. Hope this video is helpful for you to understand how this LWA works in the background, and you will be able to use this feature in going forward. So thank you for watching.